Hey, my name is Max and I'm a fat loss expert. Today I'm going to give you guys some ideas and better options that you can go for. These options are going to be lower calorie and also they're going to be a lot less fattening. Everyone knows that we have carbs, protein, and fat as macronutrients. However, most people don't know that alcohol itself is actually a calorie. 1 gram of carbs or protein is equivalent to 4 calories. 1 gram of fat has 9 calories. And 1 gram of alcohol has 7 calories. So it's more than carbs and it's more than protein. It's a little less than fat, but it is very high in calories. The reason for this is that alcohol is made from fermenting starches and sugar. So that is a big reason why alcohol alone is fattening, and that's not even including all the extra sugar that people add to their drinks. So since we know that alcohol is a calorie, and when we drink alcohol, there's no way to avoid the calories from alcohol itself. What we can do is we can avoid excess calories from sugar that we add to our drinks. And many people don't even know that when you go to the store and you get the flavored versions of your favorite alcoholic beverage, in order to flavor it, they have to add a whole bunch of sugar to that drink. And they usually come with a lower alcohol percentage. So for example, an unflavored bottle of vodka will have 40% alcohol in it, whereas a flavored bottle of vodka will have 35% alcohol in it and also have more sugar added to it in order to give it that flavor. So not only is the sugar added in, but also the alcohol to sugar ratio is affected. So you're getting more sugar, less alcohol, and you'll probably end up having to drink more, which is an endless cycle of more calories. So my best recommendation for that would be go for the alcohol that's just plain flavored. If you have to have some kind of chaser with it, or if you want to mix it with something, go for the diet sodas and the Crystal Light and try to mix that with it, because that's going to have a lot less sugar. Even though these aren't the healthiest options, they are going to help you cut back on extra calories that you'll be getting from having those sugary beverages. As far as picking the alcohol itself, we want to pick one with the fewest calories. It would make sense that the ones that are higher in alcohol percentage and lower with sugar would be best for somebody that's trying to watch their calories. Everclear is 95% alcohol and pretty much 5% water. There is no sugar added, it's just plain old alcohol. So Everclear is a great option, especially if you want to be tripping all over yourself. Next, the recommendation that I usually make for my clients is to just have regular, plain, unflavored vodka. After vodka comes gin, after that comes your rum, your tequila, your whiskey, and then comes red wine and beer. Many of you might find articles and other information out there that tells you that red wine is amazing and it's great for health benefits and whatnot, and that may even be the case. However, wine is high in sugar, so in relation to fat burning, I wouldn't have the wine. Between red wine and white wine, red wine is better than white wine calorie wise. However, like I said, wine and beer, I would just avoid it because there's a whole ton of additional calories that are being added on to the alcohol calories that are in that drink. And generally with drinks like beer, because there's less alcohol, you're gonna have to drink more of it and you're gonna get more of the extra calories that are in that beer. Now, no matter which alcoholic beverage you choose to drink, alcohol itself has negative consequences not only on the body, but more specifically on muscle building. So if you're stunting your muscle growth, you're also going to slow down your metabolism, which in turn will slow down the fat loss that you experience during your program. The other problem with alcohol itself is that when alcohol is introduced into your system, the same organs that were once responsible for converting stored body fat into energy, which is what fat loss really is, are now primarily responsible for getting that alcohol out of your body and out of your system and cleansing your body of all those toxins. And last but not least, one of the most fattening effects of alcohol is the fact that it turns you into a pig. And I don't mean with the ladies, I'm talking about with your appetite. Not only does it decrease your willpower to stay away from those bad foods once you've been drinking, but it also increases your appetite and makes you crave even more of those bad foods once you start eating them. But hey, it might be your friend's birthday, it might be a holiday, it might be a big event. Things come up and you probably will drink. But when you're choosing the type of alcohol that you drink, remember to go with one of those low calorie options. And remember to make it as sugar free as possible. If you guys enjoyed today's video and would like to see more videos like this, you can subscribe to my channel. Also, you could visit my website where you can do online personal training with me directly. That's all I got, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Pump it.